Good evening, my name is Hélène and welcome to your spa massage. How are you? Good, good, good. So I will be taking care of you today and we are going to learn about self-massage. So we're going to massage a part of the body that we rarely massage, and it's a shame because it is so good and a lot of tension accumulate into this part, so we're going to see that in a second. And the program is to show you a little bit on me, what we are going to do, what kind of massage, and so that you can learn to do it at home on your own, because this is the self-massage here today session, and we are going to use an oil, and then after that I will simply perform the massage on you, okay? So today what we are going to do is, hand massage. And the reason for that, it's because when we're working on an office, we use our hands a lot, and this part in particular, when we are holding our mouse and when we are typing keyboards, and at some point sometimes you've got pains. This here is a big muscle and it can be very painful. Sometimes people get stuck and they have to wear some kind of bandage. So what we are going to do is to use this, because you've got parts, and that big part is going to enter the big muscles, and the small part, the smaller parts, like for example here in between the fingers, or here for example. Like this, with it, and with this one too. So this is what we are going to learn today, okay? We will use a blend of oils composed of essential oils and vegetable oils.
So, let me show you.
That's a lot, but we are not going to necessarily use all of them. I will just introduce you to the oils in case you want to do the mix at home. And but I've done here the mix, the blend already, so that we can start very quickly. First of all, in a dropper like this, or a container, you can put one drop, 1 spoon of arnica oil, and 1 spoon of olive oil, for instance, or any other vegetable oil. Then, we're going to use a few drops of lavender. going to use a few drops of rosemary, and we will use peppermint, and finally we will use juniper. And what we're going to do is to also add one drop of vitamin E, because vitamin E helps to preserve the oils for a while when you do homemade remedies. It's also a great antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, and the good part is that you don't need a lot. The concentration is only 2 per 1,000 drops of a blend. Sportmen, because it helps when they have like muscle tensions or pains, and when they want to use a natural product instead of all the medicines that usually we are given. And if you don't have arnica, what you can do is to put a little bit more of peppermint, and you can also bit of Epsom salt. Salt is good for inflammations. It is also a disinfectant. And a lot of our oils have this type of property that we have today. So our blend is already done. Smells very good. I will just use a little bit on me. You could do this massage on your hand without oil.
I think it's better to put some,
so that is going to glide better. So I can just start by warming up my hands by just doing some movements like that on the big muscle here and all over the palm, just like so. Can also pull a little bit the fingers, and we can just start. So what I would recommend is massaging with that big ball here, massaging, just doing round motions. So you can press firmly, but not too much. If you do it on someone, you can ask if it's painful. But these muscles here are very strong, and it is hardly painful. So you can do the same. Each side, just like that. Okay.
border here. And after that you want to come quite strong in between the lines here. I can't remember how to call it. Phalanges? No, don't remember. And you're going to simply just trace like this. Now you can do like this in the middle of the hand. You can do a circle, small one, and then getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And again, bigger and bigger and bigger. What you want to do now is use this part here, small one. Here there is a hole, that kind of part that is painful when the hand is tired. I have this myself because I use a lot my mouse when I edit videos, and I have a pain sometimes, often actually. It's on the other side, on this hand, but on the right of course, because I'm right-handed. So, but I will show you on the other side. So you can use this. You can also use this one actually. You can use both. You can start by the bigger one. And you are just going to massage here. And to be honest, if you are pressing, you have a little bit of a pain. More or less actually. This is a sensitive spot here. So it's good to actually simply activate it by doing some little circular motions, or simply press on it like this. So this side here, you've got the spots here. Okay. What you can also do is to take this little part and here, under each of the fingers, you've got points. Pressure, and it's good to know that it's actually on and after on the hole also. Oh, you wanna activate those points, and you also have points right there. To activate, you can use this one also. Just like so. So you just activate them, just like this, okay? And you can massage again with this all over the hands, now that it's really warm up. Doing circular motions like that. If you do the massage on you can literally close your hand on the tool also. It can be helpful when you are actually trying to reach this spot here. You can just, maybe this big one, you can just close and move around your hand rather than the tool. You see what I mean? It could be easier like this. And what you want to do also is to you know, the acupressure spots that I told you about in the hands or the feet also. You have it's called reflexology, and all of these, let's say, dots or points, they represent organs of our body, so the fact to massage them helps also to deal with issues that we would not guess. For example, the liver could be linked, or certain, acupressure points could be linked to the liver, and then by actionating this, you can really have a good action on your liver or stuff like that. You've got the tips of your fingers that you can also activate, just like that. So you can use this little piece and activate all of them. You can be gentle, it doesn't have to be strong at all. And when you've done this side, you can also do the other side of the hand, okay, of the palm, and simply use this tool to go in between the fingers like that. Can see something because position is okay. You can do like that. You can just simply massage your hand. There's a lot of nerves also here, so it's good to massage. One thing that I like to do, whether I use that or not, to massage, but at the end of a hand massage, so I like to press each finger quite strong, but you know, moderate strong. Don't know if it exists. So I do like that. I don't know if you can see. I'm gonna try and. So what I do exactly is this. I take a finger. Sorry, I have something. I take a finger, I turn it around like this until the end, and when I'm at the end, tap like that. It's really good to twist the finger. It's so good. Really so much tension at the end. Poof, the final. Like that. So you twist, 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 up. Twist, 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 up. Twist, 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 twist. And that's a really nice feeling at the end of the fingers. So after that, you just to do exactly the same on the other side, and that's my hand that is painful because of the movements that I repetitive movements, that's the problem. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do some massage to your hand, okay? So I start by gently warming up the hand. Do a big massage of your thumb. It's painful, yeah. So I'm going to press on it a lot so that it will help you, okay? Tomorrow you will feel so much better. So I'm going to just massage the big thumb and the palm just to warm up everything. Just before to use our tool. like that. Okay, so now I will just start. And if you think that big piece we have talked about, this one, I'm gonna use it. Okay, on your big muscle, your thumb muscle. Just going to massage. Quite strong, it's a very strong muscle, there is no problem on doing this. And I would say if it's so very painful, of course, you be careful, but even if it's painful a little bit, it's totally fine. Okay. So, just massaging. Now this tool is very handy for so many things. You can do the fingers, the feet, I mean, also as well, and you can do some other parts. You can do some points, places on the face, and so much. Motions starting the center of the hand, just going larger and larger, sorry, circles that just take all the hand. Okay, and I start again from the middle, just little circles and some tracing actually. For example, you know, you can write also, it could be fun. If you don't know which what to do, you can still do that. And if your child is doing it, so then it can be fun at the same time, or it can be fun for him or her to guess what you're saying. So that's what you can do also. You can do that anywhere on the body actually, not need to do it on the end. So now what we're going to do is gonna press those little things in between the fingers here and the same here. Okay. Yeah, just press them one after the other one, and just also between the fingers, just one after the other one, and then I will end by doing this, you know, dot points here on all the fingers, the tips of the fingers. That's what I'm doing. As long as you feel relaxed. Yes, I know, hand massage is so relaxing, people have no idea. Feet also, if you don't feel it ticklish, but the hands is marvelous. Okay, so then now I will just do, you know, like this, in all of the between the fingers, and then after I will just finish by. And it will mark the end of our massage, and I hope that you've enjoyed and that you will be able to replicate at home. Don't worry, I've got a handout with all of the drawings, let's say. And so that you can remember all the movements that you can achieve, okay? Well, thank you for coming, and we hope to see you soon. So take care and see you soon.